So hello folks, this is Garth at GW Leathercraft, and today we're going to do another gun belt. This one, rough oat. My plan is to recreate a reasonable facsimile of the gun belt worn by Clint Eastwood in The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, and several others. Now, keep in mind that I don't intend to make this a perfect copy. Don't even know if I could, but I have no intention of attempting it. Exactly. I'm going to try to make it somewhat similar. Just so we are clear, some of the things that I find, some of the points with the rough oat holster that Clint Eastwood wore that you see when you look at it, the buckle strap on the holster, it's a relatively simple holster, but it's edge sewn, rough oat of course, and the it's lined with the grain side is on touching the pistol. It also, the belt has gunslinger stitching, or it's that fancy stitching on it. Oiled finish on the rough oat, and we're starting with the belt now. The nearest dimensions I could get for the belt are 2 3/4, so that's what I cut it. I don't think it's a 3-inch. It doesn't look like a 3-inch, so, and it looks wider than 2.5, so I'm guessing at that, but that's what I would say. So with my pattern of Eastwood style, I cut the blank 10 inches longer than what I wanted for girth size. And we're just going to mark out our ends. Now this is natural leather from Tandy, 10 to 11 ounce, and of course the rough oat. The one thing, I have made these before, and you have to be extremely careful. Because of the, you wouldn't think it, but for some reason the rough oat is terribly delicate and it shows up marks like ridiculous. So have to forgive my head. the thinness of the material for the lace, it's not quite 6 to 7 ounce. So I believe that's going to be good enough. With 6 to 7 ounce, I would have to width out those slots. So this is getting lined, so it will want to be edge sewn. I've got to find my template for the gunslinger stitching, and I'll be right back. So, after finding the templates, these are, they're from Tandy, but they're made by Maker's Leather Supply. They have 3 templates in the set. None of them really work for the 2 3/4 inch belt, but we'll just make the plaster fit the sore. Now, I don't feel like there's enough room below here for anything, so I'm going to omit it. I'm just going to go with that. I am going to sew that now before I put the lace in. You could wait and do it with the lining, but I see no reason to I don't need the extra stitches for the lining, and I'll do it now. So I'm going to swing you around so you can watch. So, we got the gunslinger stitching completed. Now we're ready for the lace. I've already soaked this. Being natural, it's pretty easy to soak. And given how flexible and well this
place is, I'm not going to be able to stretch it, pull as hard on it as I do with the other stuff. I left the end there undone, but and I'm using 38s this time instead of 45. I'm going to do the rest off camera and I'll come back. So we got the lace done and I'm going to take the shells out of it and let it dry, and then we'll come back and put the lining on. So we're back. It's the next evening. I let the bullet lace dry. I put the suede on the back and glued it just because it was easier for me to do that off camera. On this end, I only let it run till there, okay, because there's no point in it being out under the buckle. So we're going to sew it now. I'd sew it. So I'll move you over so you can watch some of that.
So the edge sewing is done. So now we just gotta trim this. So I'm going to sand the edge on this and I'll come back. So the edges are sanded. I'm gonna finish this up and I'll bring you back. So I got the edge beveling done. So now we're going to do the slicking, burnishing, whatever you want to call it. One thing I will mention about using this rough out leather, you have to be very careful not to get marks on it. It's quite delicate that way.
So that is what we're going to do. Going to do that all the way around. And I'll bring you back. So, we get the edges burnished. And that probably isn't going to show up. But they're nice and smooth. Finished with Tokenol. And before we put the buckle on, I decided to oil it. This is an oil finish, but which is likely what the original had. But again, like I said previously in this, I'm not exact trying to copy it, obviously, but in some ways an oil finish is nice anyway. Now the only thing with an oil finish is you can make a mess of it. You want to put on a coat and try to get it as even as possible, because you can manipulate the amount of oil that goes into stuff and end up with something that you don't want. So I just go over everything once and call it good enough. And try to put on the same amount across the whole thing. And I'm not going to do the inside of the lace, just because I don't want that getting too saturated. Now that is about all I'm going to do with that. It'll lighten up when it dries. That's boiled linseed oil, in case anybody's wondering. Or no, sorry. That's neat's foot oil, in case anybody's wondering. And hopefully we didn't get any on the back. So, I'm going to let this dry for now. Well, I'll bring you back when I put the buckle on. So we're back. The neat's foot oil has dried. I went over the edges and give them a little rub with cloth again, and
we're just going to put the buckle on, and then this belt will be done. Okay, I'll set these. So there's the belt. So there you go. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next one.